So yo, welcome, episode 1.1, Connect the Dots podcast, episode 1. We're here, okay, yeah. So you already read the title, so you already know. Basically, this episode, we're going to be breaking down what Connect the Dot is, where we started, to where we're at now, and what's next, right? Because a lot of people have been asking, we've been on a hiatus.
That's
for
what
a
it is.
I feel like I've been on vacation, myself.
Really? You know, there's a lot of factors going on right now.
I mean, there's COVID,
there's a lot of things. COVID, family.
Family as well.
You know,
well,
I mean, everybody's been doing their thing, you know. I know you've been living your life, though, man.
I've been going crazy, bro.
You've been living your life. Just went out west. Talk about that. Like,
okay, well, you know, I'll talk about it briefly, but I mean, I don't want to go too crazy. But I mean, yeah, I went out west and I was filming some music videos. I was enjoying myself a bit, but I filmed 8 music videos and a commercial in 5 days, technically.
So you're busy.
I've been busy, man. I'm also having a kid in at the end of April.
Okay, congrats.
So, thanks, brother. That's number 4.
Yeah.
So, you've been busy yourself. Do I see you coaching, like, are you coaching the Raptors now? Or what did I see there?
No, I'm not coaching the Raptors. I'm coaching my teams. I'm, you know, shout-outs to my peoples, shout-outs. You know, shout out to my Gators boys. You know, right now they're doing their thing.
Yeah, a lot of people don't know that about Mr. Mike Gutz. He's a man of many talents.
Yeah,
he's
man.
Not just a rapper, bro. And that's like, to be honest, that's what linked us together, me and Gutz. Like, you know, I've never been just a this or just a that. I've always been a jack of all trades, you know, master of none, if you will. But, you know, I like to think I'm pretty skilled in a lot of different areas. But anyways, man, we linked together on Connect the Dot. Let's talk quickly about what Connect the Dot is. Basically, it's a hip-hop performance series, right?
Hip-hop performance series, you know, we basically, you know, put a shout out to all the artists that are in the region and the area, say, hey, you know, if you got the skills, what it takes to be, you know, the top MC, top artist of, you know, the whole city, you know, you come to the stage, you do your thing, you know, we give out prizes, we give out, like, opportunities, etc. So it's just a showcase of talent of, like, you know, artists from everywhere and you know, building them, building the bridge together and building the city and together.
Connecting the dots. So, like, but yeah, no, like, the cool thing about Connect the Dot, though, too, is, like, the format of the show. So we do, like, different shows, but started off with just one big show a year.
Yeah.
And we would, you know, get artists from different areas of the GTA. They would all come. We would do a big performance. And it started off at Nocturne in Toronto.
Yeah.
Big shout out to Nocturne. You already know, legendary spot. So rest in peace, Nocturne as well. But
yeah, you know, Matt Almeida, you know, big ups to him. Like
Spencer,
like, yo, he opened the door for a lot of, you know, MCs to do their thing, right?
That place, if you guys don't know about Nocturne, it's like a smaller venue, but just a really dope venue, like, for, like, up-and-comers, like, to come in. Small room, nice and straight, sound was always good, they had, like, nice lighting, a nice little stage, like, made you feel good, you know, like you weren't on the floor anymore at the pubs and shit.
If she doesn't know about Nocturne, she's too young for
she's
you,
too
bro.
Young for you. She's for the streets now.
That's true enough.
That's funny. But yeah, so we started off at Nocturne, and once a year or so, we would do this big event where we would bring all these artists from different areas, and then we would have, you know, 2 people would win prizes, you know, first place, second place would win prizes based off of judges, and then the 3rd place would always be a crowd reaction, they would get a prize as well. And
I've never been a fan of the crowd reaction.
I like that one, actually, to be honest, because especially in certain cases where the guy that didn't bring the most people gets the best crowd reaction and actually wins that 3rd place slot. It's
for
like,
that,
that's
for,
gold.
For that particular format, yes. But if you go, like,
most places,
if it's like, yo, crowd reaction, it's like, is this guy, this guy? And then it's like a popularity contest. Like, the worst guy can win, right?
No,
like,
I feel that. That's why he gets 3rd, though.
Yeah.
That's why it's like, you know, crowd reaction, you only get 3rd place. And they don't get the craziest prize pack, but they get something.
Yeah,
right?
They
like
get
a
something.
Pat on the back, right?
Yeah, they get
a little something. So we started off in Nocturne, and but that's basically the format. The format is like this: so you artists come, they perform 2 songs, raw vocals over beats. So it's like, it's kind of like the old school way of rapping, where the beat plays and the rapper raps. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
But on the hooks, we were allowing people to leave their hook in. So sometimes it's a sample, sometimes there's someone singing, sometimes the artist is singing, or it's just layered a lot. So we allow them.
I can't believe it's 2021 and artists are still doing that.
But it makes sense in certain cases. Like, if you're on a big performance and a big stage and it's a big concert venue, then it makes sense, because a lot of times they can't hear in the sound system shit anyways, and you kind of need the music to back it. But in the small intimate venues that have dope little sound systems, You shouldn't need that if you're a sick lyricist.
Man, I think rappers should have, like, yo, they can play their doubles and, like, they're
making their back. Mic check.
Yo, relax, yo. But, I think, like, yeah, they should have, like, maybe just their back ends. Like,
the ad libs?
No, not the ad libs. The back, like, you know, the doubles, I guess. The emphasis.
See, lines. This is the one thing that we talked about this a long time ago, back before episode one, but back before concert one, show one.
Yeah.
Was, are they allowed to bring a hype man? And then we opted out of hype men, and we said,
did
no,
I don't think
we did at first, and then we said yeah, and then we said no. And
but
then
I don't think any artist really came with a hype man.
That's what
I don't think it was like. I don't think it was like a thing where it was like we made it a, oh, you can't have a hype man.
Okay.
We never really talked about that.
No,
right?
I remember we talked about it behind the scenes, but I always was actually for the hype man. Because
I love the hype man.
I think there should be somebody doing your backup.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Like, I think the hype man, I think it has like the most important job.
Agreed.
You know what I mean? You know, it's one thing for the artist to like spit his lines, but like that's the artist, that's your shit. Like,
yeah,
you should know your shit.
Yeah.
But another person to know your shit more, like to know, like, okay, I gotta make sure I know this line
right here
and know that line.
Oh,
I know,
and he kind of messes up here.
He comes
up,
I gotta go
heavy.
Oh,
here
he goes. Oh, if he, like, for whatever reason he fucks up, I can't just jump in and spit like lines. Like, I don't know if you like follow Benny the Butcher.
Not really. I don't follow, but I've heard his music. I like his music.
I was watching this online performance that they did. It was like it was an empty theater or venue, and it was like all of Griselda there, whatever. But the reason why I bring it up is because one of his artists that are on his label, his name is Heem. He was like his hype man, and like this guy is like, in the whole year, like, he's just been jumping on everything, like in that circle, whatever. He's been jumping on everything.
Okay,
but like, when you hear this guy, like, as a hype man, like, this guy's got him, like,
sick.
Every line, like, just, he had him, like, bam, bam.
I love to see that shit.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because some hype man's like, you know, you've been to shows where it's like, buddy, you're the hype man.
Yeah.
And the mans will fuck up, and he's still there just...
Yeah, rocking it out.
Rocking it out, like, bro, you're the hype man. Like,
yeah, that's like you with Specz, like, you guys have such a good dynamic.
Yeah.
You guys are crazy. Like you guys should be putting on, like, a school for artists, like, you know what I mean? Like, you guys really know how to, like, fucking ride off each other's vibes and, like, back each other up. You guys know each other's stuff, and you guys are always in sync, I find. But, but that's a little bit of backstory about Connect the Dot and stuff like that. Getting into the first event, like, to kind of show you guys where we started off at Nocturne Nightclub, like I had mentioned. It was a one-off show. We had about 20 artists or so that were on the bill.
When was that?
This was Saturday, May 17th, 2014.
Wow, May 17th?
Yeah.
Wow.
So that's like, we're almost coming up to the 7th year anniversary right now.
7 years.
7th year anniversary for Connect the Dot, which is pretty big.
That's
pretty
huge.
Crazy. So, we started off, and our first guest judge was actually, like, to keep this thing whole full circle and everything, our first guest judge was G Wonder.
Wow.
G fucking Wonder.
Shout out to G Wonder.
Yo, shout out to G Wonder, because G Wonder is a OG, and back then, I believe it was me that actually reached out to G, because me and G had been talking, because with the captured film stuff, I had been getting much fat grants and stuff like that. So me and G, I was kind of looked up to him as like a mentor, really, to be honest, because he's an OG in the game. Like, he was on the Much Fat thing.
Yeah.
Like, you know, I don't know exactly details about that to be specific, but he was definitely a behind the scenes OG guy in the industry, still is. And you're actually, like, back then, did you really know him actually back then?
When I met G through the scene, right?
Mm-hmm,
like,
mm-hmm.
You know, I actually had my own radio show. Man, I want to say back in like 08, 09 times.
Oh, shit.
I had my own radio show on Fusion Radio, and we ran that for a while.
Okay.
And I remember we did an interview with G.
Okay.
He couldn't make it, but he did the interview on the phone.
Nice.
And I think T-Major, that was when T-Major was on the label. And, but anyways, like, I had a show, and I remember, like, fucking the first experience with that guy, was fucked up because I was with this crew called I Respect Music, and fucking, you know, like one of those events where you have like 15, 20 artists on the fucking bill. It's like one of those like fucking dumb off fucking.
But like each of them have 15 minutes.
Yeah, and it just gets whatever. And for whatever reason, G got pushed back. I mean, like I was just like hosting it, but like people were like getting on that were like
we're supposed to be getting on,
right? And it's like whatever. So like, you know, situation. G kind of felt a ways, whatever. Like, and I was like, and I was cheese, right? I was like, fuck, cause I didn't want to burn that bridge, whatever. So I like hit him up and I told him, like, yo, like, you know, my bad. So like, what happened, whatever. And you know, it was like one of those like, you know, like he just like told me, he's like, yo, I was fucked up, blah blah blah. But
yeah,
like, you know, he kind of like he like said, yo, I respect you for like coming true and like, you know, correcting it, kind of thing. Mm-hmm. So like, I knew like he was on a positive vibe from there. So like, that was like when I first like, you know, encountered with G.
Right.
But you know, then like fast forward, he like was doing the future beats and like, you know, he said like, yo, I want you to get on one of my beats, and then he sent me Gut Check Time.
Oh no way, he did Gut Check that?
Yeah.
That's dope.
So I was just like, I was like, oh shit. So I did Gut Check Time on that. Fucking did it. He blessed you, you know, he came true on the video, whatever. You know, so from them times, and then with the new album now, right, like with the album Nostradamus, he's the one that introduced me to Nostradamus, and then that's when we did G Notes. So like, for those who don't know, like, you know, go get my album, it's out right now. I'm plugging my shit. Like,
what are you
know,
doing, bro? You're not supposed. No, I'm just
what is that the rule? Is that the official rule right now?
Yeah, right.
Nah, that's the Rockette plug my shit.
Yo, it's funny actually that we that said because back when we first started this shit with Connect the Dot, I remember like me and Gutz sat down and like, you know, I was doing my own thing with events, he was doing his own thing. I was kind of like the East End cat, he was kind of like the cat in the West End that I, he was like my plug in the West End, to be honest, back then. Like, other than like, I obviously I had some, but you were my main guy, to be honest.
Well, West End for you.
For me, yeah.
Yeah, West End for you.
Well, to be honest, I mean, we were doing shows at Nocturne, which is, I mean,
that's
Queen Street. That's pretty West End to me.
Yeah, but I mean, yeah, for sure. Like,
that's West End to anyone, really. Yeah, I don't know.
But
that's,
I'm like, you know.
You're a Scarborough cat, so you're kind of East End of Toronto, but you're not as far East as me. So yeah, for those that don't know, you know what I mean? Like, I'm not, when I say East End cat, I'm talking Durham region, right? So basically we linked up and it was like, okay, boom. We kind of joined forces, but with Connect the Dot, it was a whole different venture. Like, cause we had already linked up on other events and we'd done like a 1-2 show and stuff like that. Smoke. And then basically when we linked with Connect the Dot, we kind of had similar goals with connecting artists and just kind of getting artists from different cities and doing big shows in Toronto and stuff like that. And getting good artists, not just like anybody, but the best artists from each city and making them compete in Toronto. And that's what our original first goal was just getting them. And then, you know, we had a joke between us, which was like, okay, but you're not allowed to promote your stuff. This isn't the Mike Gutz show and stuff. So, you know, it's always the Mike Gutz show. But you know what? He's earned his keep. He's allowed to drop plugs whenever he wants. But anyways,
G-Notes
cop the album. Make sure you do. We're going to put the link in the description for sure, obviously. For sure, social medias will be in the description, all that stuff. And if you're following along,
all that shit,
and you already know us, you should be supporting the cat anyways. Like, come on, bro. The guy's been putting in the time, right?
I mean, yo, just give me my roses while I'm here.
That's it, bro.
That's what's up, man.
So Connect the Dots. Connect the Dot 1, we linked up, we were like, okay, boom, let's call it Connect the Dot.
So that was 2014.
Okay. Gutz actually had the, I think you guys came up with the name initially or something,
so
right?
So, like, yeah, I remember I, like, had the idea. Yeah, me and Specz, like, yo, we had the idea. I had the idea.
Yeah.
Right to you.
I was already doing hip hop.
You were doing all that shit. Like, you were doing
hip hop championship thing with Organik. Sergeant Pepper's, yeah.
I remember that.
And I had Organik as a main
judge. Yeah.
And that's why even when we linked up with this Connected Dot, my whole goal from even stage one
was to
get Organik as a
guy
judge
that was in
Connected Dot.
Who was that guy that was doing shit in at your place at Pepper's? Big white guy.
Brett Williams.
No, rapper. Oh my gosh, I'm drawing a blank right now. Fuck.
Big white rapper?
Yeah, man.
Fat white rapper, you mean?
No, fat, but yeah, I guess you could say. But he's out there, like,
Massacre?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
You did that show. I remember that show.
That was you remember that show.
I got on that. That was like one of the first. That was one of the first shows I got on. Was on that one.
That was your first impression of Dan Barker.
Right? Yeah, I think that was one of the first.
That was one of the worst shows to date that I can even think of on the top of my head. To date. Like, I've done hundreds of events by this point. I've done hundreds.
Yeah.
To date, 2021, I could say that that was the worst event that I have ever
Are you
ran.
Serious?
Bro, there was fight after fight after fight. It was
Yo, we went on in this whole fight.
It didn't stop.
Yo.
It didn't
every
stop.
Every event, yo.
I've never had an event like that ever since then. And I made that was like the that was like the benchmark. That was like the benchmark of events. I was like, okay, we can't get there.
I remember that event. Yo.
That was the worst.
It was a Halloween. Oh my gosh.
It was Halloween.
It was some shit like that. Yeah. Yo, that was some shit. Yeah.
I have crazy memory like that.
Yeah, I remember that shit. That was like the first event that I ever got on.
That was the first and last time I think that guy ever performed.
I remember, yeah.
So, but moving on, we obviously we linked up on Connect the Dot. Connect the Dot number one. Connect the Dot number one, where are we? Okay, so we have G Wonder as our main judge. We're at Nocturne Nightclub.
I'm gonna try and guess who
we're
won this.
We're at May 17th. We also have myself as a special guest judge. That's see how I put myself on though, and I'm talking smack about you.
So exactly.
But yet I'm there, like, why are you such a special guest judge? That's actually true though, facts. Yo, G Wonder got his plug though. Yo, shout out to G.
Yeah.
Made sure he got his link.
Yeah.
Okay, so quickly, over the list of artists, we had Dusty Wallace. Oh my God, this Dusty Wallace. Bro, this was the time that and this is another thing that sticks out in my head. This is what I'm saying, I have a weird memory. This guy had pink bunny slippers on, bro.
Yes, I think I remember that.
I guess it worked though because I still remember the damn slippers. So
yeah.
Shout out to Dusty Wallace. The guy had good music and good energy too.
Yeah.
He just had weird slippers. Young Smitty, Mr. Burns, Rob Self and M Class, RK No Love. I bet you he RK No Showed.
Yeah.
RK No Love No Showed. I guarantee it.
Yeah.
He got put on the blacklist. That's back when I was doing the blacklist thing too.
Hey.
So if you didn't
have
show up
you have to do the blacklist.
You didn't show up to one of my events back in, you were banned for 1 year if you didn't show. Like if I didn't have a good enough excuse, and people would give me the craziest excuses after I did this too. 1 year, but that was.
I banned people for life.
And people fucking hated it. They were mad at me for that, bro. I got a lot of hate for that, but I got a lot of love too by people being like, "Good job, you should do that."
Straight up.
And people wanted me to share the list with them. Like, I don't want to book them either.
Yeah, exactly. Because like, as you have to be respectful. Like, as an artist, as a human being, like, if you can't make it somewhere, just like, let a person know at least.
Yeah, and it's an indie show or local. Like, if you don't show up, you don't show up. Whatever, bro. We'll put somebody ahead of you. But like, let us know so we can let other people.
Yeah,
know.
Just say like,
and then that way you have credibility still.
Don't not show up, and then I don't know what happened to you. It's like, what the hell?
I've actually genuinely been checking on people. Like, bro, like, are you good, though? Like, it's a snowy day, maybe, or something.
Yeah,
you know
what
I mean? Like,
for sure.
But, so, keeping it going here. RK, No Love, No Showed. Get Stoked. Get Stoked.
Yeah.
He's dope, right? He's dope, no?
Yeah, I Get Stoked, for sure.
Yeah, and then Dre Specz. Well, that was his first appearance on the Connect the Dot show.
I don't think he attended that one.
You're saying that you don't think he showed up?
I don't think he showed up for that one.
And Dre Specz is not that kind of guy.
He is not that kind of guy.
So he must have had a valid reason.
I think so. I don't
because
think
otherwise
he showed up
been
for that
blacklisted.
One. Because, you know why?
Maybe he was blacklisted.
No, he was... maybe.
I might have blacklisted
Maybe Specz. I blacklisted him. That's only a fuck...
No, he might have been on a fuck Danny for 1 year.
No. For whatever reason, because I know that like
he must have had a good reason.
Yeah, he would have. I think he would have been a standout performer. In that
okay,
one.
I see what you're saying.
You know what I mean? Because I know who won this one.
Then we had Menace. Then we had Franchise. Then we had Iambic. Then we had J Webb. Then we had Jesse.
Kid
James.
Menace.
I'm not sure. It just says Menace.
I think
really
it's
sure.
Menace. I think if it's the same Menace, I'm thinking of you. That kid is sick. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then we had. Franchise, J Webb, Jesse James, Bobby Pell, Noah Moses, who was pretty good, Black Gang, Ghost, who I remember
Ghost,
being sick.
Yeah,
he's so dope, bro.
Okay.
He was my favorite in THC.
Yeah.
No offense. Then we had CHB, then we had Stalin, and then we had
CHB
Q to
was
Fifth.
In it?
Yeah,
Really?
Bias as shit. But yeah, we had Q to Fit, then we had Freestyler. So that's a wide range of places too. We got people from everywhere here, Durham region to Mississauga to Barrie to all over the place. So we really, this was where our idea already came to fruition by bringing talented artists from different areas. We put them on stage, and who won? Who did you say?
I am Vic
took the dub, yes. And they deserved it. They're insane. They're no longer a crew anymore.
Yeah. I know that they were doing things for a while. Mm-hmm. And then, you didn't hear much from them. But
right.
I remember those guys. Yeah, they did a couple of my shows, man.
Same,
a couple
of
my, like, yo, they always came deep. Like, you
same,
know,
yeah,
like,
yeah,
they always,
yeah,
like,
yeah,
like, they always came with a crew.
And they always cared about their performance. They always, like, practiced it and stuff. So that was cool.
Like, so... You know, like, yeah, those guys did their thing.
But, I mean, like, Dusty Wallace was, he's a good performer. Like,
yeah,
he's
Dusty always does his thing.
Young Smitty, he's pretty good. I like his music.
Young Smitty's been around for a while.
Mr. Burns, he's one of those raw spitters. He was perfect for Connect the Dots.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he was pretty good.
Yeah.
I don't remember Rob Self in M-Class.
Doesn't stand out to me.
And then we got, like, Get Stoked, Dre Specs, obviously.
Yeah.
I Am Vic, who won it.
Yeah.
Franchise and Menace. I'm not sure.
Yeah.
Jesse James, I don't know if that's...
What, from Scarborough?
I don't know. I'm not sure. I don't remember, to be honest.
Because I swear there was another Jesse James.
But there's a white Jesse James, and then there's, like, a black Jesse James. I think this might have been the black Jesse James.
Yeah?
I think so, too. Because I think he was on one of my shows before, and this might have been the only one.
Well, the white Jesse James is doing big things, though. I like what he's doing still.
Dope.
Yeah.
So then we got Bobby Pell. And then we got Noah Moses. We got Black Gang. We got Ghost.
Black
we got
Gang,
CHB. Stalin. And yeah. So we got people.
Stalin?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Stalin was on that show?
Yeah, bro. So that was episode one, 2014, 7 years ago.
Who were the judges? G-Wonder?
G-Wonder, yeah. Myself, and S. Don Perignon. And then we go...
For some reason, I don't think S. Don Perignon was there.
Yeah, he was.
Yeah?
Yeah, yeah. And Jammin, too. His manager, Jammin. I shot a video for him, and then me and him kind of got tight, and then... Yeah,
oh, nice.
So then, Connect the Dot number two.
Let's
move moving on here. Connect the Dot number two, we went to Whitby, because remember... We tried out your ends.
Yeah.
We went the first one. We were in Toronto.
Yeah.
Nocturne. Solid.
Yeah.
Solid venue.
Yeah.
And I said, you know what? Let's do it Whippy style and let's go to Barney's.
I remember Barney's. Barney's.
Barney's.
Barney's.
Nice venue though. Nice venue.
Yo, Barney's was a sick venue.
That stage.
That was a hidden gem.
Yep. Beautiful,
like,
spot. The sound guy was insane. He
how'd
did
you
stuff
find Barney's?
Rocking. To be honest, I think Barney's found me.
Really?
Yeah. It's one of those ones where I believe the venue owner reached out to me asking me to do some shows at his. He wanted because he had seen
really?
Me doing shows in the area, and so then I went and seen the venue and I was like, holy crap! Like, what's going on here? Like, let's go.
Mm-hmm.
And he actually didn't charge me anything, and he paid for the sound guy, paid for the security, but you know, he made his money, and I brought people to his bar. He didn't. There was no one going there. It was empty.
There's another, there's a couple artists that came through that place.
I brought a few there. I brought Slain,
yeah.
And then I think I brought Alpha Omega or whatever, maybe, or whatever.
I think I got on that Slain track show.
Did you? It was a good show.
Yeah.
It was actually really good.
I think I got on that Slain show.
So we were here, and this was the, so who did we have here? We had the audience will choose the winner. Assisted by our panel of judges. Special guest performance by Mike Gutz. And then we had it's okay, my name wasn't on it this time, yours was. So cool. One for one. That's the
listen.
You were just getting even.
Yeah.
Because your name wasn't on the last one.
Well, I'm saying. Like
well your logo was. Big enough where you could actually read your name. But anyway, so the artist lineup was challenge accepted.
Are people gonna not know my name then?
Yinaki Knox, Fletcher G, Strategist, Bandit Enrico, Heavyweight, Spotty G, Swish Up Styles, SOB, Big Nate, Roberts, AG, Spenny, Ace, C Trills, Breezy,
a lot of these guys.
Brown Bag Money, Dirty, Smoking Section, K Rins, Young Smitty Came Back, Caliente, Prince Black, Q to Fifth. Wow, a lot of names, man. Familiar names too, from all over the place. Like this is Toronto to literally Mississauga to literally Etobicoke to Oshawa to Sarnia. Spotty G's from Sarnia. Jesus Christ. People are from all over the place.
That's crazy.
All to Whitby. Connect the dot for real. That's we're doing what we said we were doing.
Barney's was a spot.
Barney's was
didn't last long.
It didn't last long. The guy didn't own it for long. I think he only had the lease for about a year and then he had to give it up. But he owned a few other restaurants and
that had the levels, right?
It had the pool lounge upstairs, but it was almost too big. Like you needed big artists.
Yeah.
And to be honest, I'm not big on bringing these big American artists into the venues, but I did show it to PJ. PJ was gonna do some shows there, but he had the Oshawa spot. So he was always loyal to them, right? He could have easily went to Barney's, got it for free, and probably made more money even. Maybe not, though, because, you know, his relationship with Oshawa. So who knows, right? Music hall.
No, and you couldn't oversaturate it with Oshawa and Whitby.
It was a nice venue, though. Like, the layout was
It was a nice venue.
But it was very similar to the other one.
You know what was a nice venue? Was Rockpile East.
Very nice venue.
Which was Rumors.
Yeah.
Right?
Very nice venue.
But
my favorite, actually, was Mustache Club. My favorite venue for some reason. It's just like Nocturne, but it was like the stage was nicer, like the overall lighting I liked better. The sound guy was like the sound was always so on point.
Yeah.
The only thing I didn't like is it was up the stairs, but same with Nocturne.
Yeah.
But okay, so with this we said so who do you think won this? We're on Connect the Dot 2. We're at Barney's.
We're at Barney's? I'm gonna say that it was Smoking Section.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah, I remember they won that. They had a crew full of
seven people.
Like seven
MCs, six dudes, one chick.
Yep.
Crash.
I remember that shit. I was like,
oh man,
I was
they
like,
were
whoa,
all
what the
individually
fuck?
Dope. And then like as a group, it was just like it was like Wu-Tang.
But yeah,
it was like Canada's
for sure.
Wu-Tang. A lot of people were saying that like underground local cats, like they were like, yo, this is Canada's. And honestly, they could have got dubbed that way and maybe done vinyl and done like maybe done some cool stuff. But I mean. It's got to be tough to like put like be in a seven man band, like you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, that's got to be hard. I don't know, but
for sure.
They were really sick. So yeah, they came in first place, and then second place I believe was man. I don't remember.
I don't even remember either, man.
I'm sure I can go look here. I'll post it up here on the screen. Second place was I think it was Brown Bag Money. It was Brown Bag Money.
Was it?
Yeah, it was. For some reason, I remember it being Brown Bag Money. It had to have been Brown Bag Money. It might not have been, but if it was somebody different, I'll pop it.
Was it the same Brown Bag Money?
Brown Bag Money, yeah. Danielson and...
Was it the same ones?
I believe so, because they used to roll Smoking Section heavy. When I did the Smoking Section tour. Because Smoking Section won this, I did a tour for them.
Yeah.
And the tour that I did for them, Brown Bag Money was on it.
Yeah, you're right.
And that tour was actually really dope.
Yeah.
One of the best tours I did.
Yeah. You're right, so...
So that was that, and that was Saturday, November 22nd at Barney's.
Okay.
Doesn't say the year, but I think that was the 2015. Then we go to the third. The third, back to Nocturne. Gutz said, enough's enough. I've seen enough of this whippy shit.
Listen,
we're going back to Toronto.
Yo, people need to appreciate Nocturne.
True.
For what it was,
true.
Man. Like Nocturne was a good spot.
Mm-hmm.
If you're an artist and you're just, you know, trying to like get your feet wet with this whole like performance and, you know, being like on a stage and with the bright lights, whatever, like Nocturne's a good spot, good start off spot. You know what I mean?
Great venue.
And it's like even as a promoter, you could do like so many different events there.
I love that venue. I did so many different events there. They came so clutch for me so many times. And like you're right, you can do so many different kinds of events. I've shot videos there. I've done R&B shows. I've done hip hop.
That was actually
comedy.
That was actually the very first. That was the very first location we did the red carpet treatment.
Oh really?
Yeah, Red Carpet Treatment was at Nocturne.
And that's crazy too that you brought that up, Red Carpet Treatment, is because Matt Almeida, the guy that hooked us up with Nocturne, big shout outs to Matt. I think we might have already given him shout outs earlier, but shout him out. You can never give him too many shout outs.
Yeah.
And he lined up a sick spot, which was actually a movie theater venue that actually Gutz like innovated this idea, which I always thought was insane. I always gave him mad props for it, and I still do, is
the red carpet treatment
and but at Big Picture Cinema.
At Big Picture Cinema.
Is what it was. But that was kind of like the branding of it all, though. Yeah, it was the red carpet treatment at Big Picture Cinema. Yeah, yeah. Like, because to me, that's what stood out. Like, the red carpet treatment already kind of draws you in a bit, like a little bit. But when you see Big Picture Cinema, what the hell? Like, what's he talking about?
That was just luck right there. Like, what I mean? Like, just to have that, opportunity,
Right in the hood, too.
Yeah. It was, in a very sketchy area.
Literally in the hood.
Very sketchy area.
And, honestly,
But we never had problems.
No, because we were all good people. Like, everyone was good people.
We never had problems. Like, we did so many red carpet treatments. Mm-hmm. So many,
just events in general.
Events in general, and we never had problems, man. Right, knock on wood. We never had problems.
And nothing that we couldn't de-escalate, too. Like, because people usually, go to events, don't really know who the promoter is, don't really know who's whatever, they just go and then they don't care about what they do. Yeah. But then when they're at a Gutz event or if they're at Barker's event, they might think twice, especially if they see that Barker knows or Gutz sees it.
But the thing is that
the respect thing, though.
Yeah, it's just it's more community based.
It is, and it's about knowing your people, putting the right people on the show. Right?
A lot of these events and shows, it's like, you knew this guy's on, or I know this guy. Like, everybody kind of knew each other, And it's everyone kind of had a respect and
Big Picture Cinema, red carpet treatment. Basically, what Gutz did was he would grab local artists from the area, and what he would do is he would actually premiere their music videos. So all the artists, so there could be 10, 15, maybe sometimes 20 artists.
So basically, we just made it an experience where it's like we were in an old theater and, we play the music video and you sit there and we had the luxury to smoke in there and
drink and do our thing
and everything was low key and everything was proper and that was the experience. The thing that was so epic about it
that I thought was that not only so Gutz gets to kind of get the venue right. He gets to put a ticket price on the front door, and then he gets to let the artists get tickets, let's say, and invite their friends and family and fans to actually come to the event, so they actually get to interact with the artist, be there, watch their video with them, premiered for the very first time before anybody. They don't even release it to the public until after that event. And that's a big part of it. And then at the same time, he's giving the artist opportunity to make money. So the ticket, and also it's not like he's charging $20 or $30 or $40 $50. And it's maybe $15.
And you know what the funny
bucks.
Thing is? And you know what the funny thing is about that? Mm. Is that I'll bring that idea to an artist. And
right.
Say, hey, so I'm just, I'm just saying I'm giving artists 15 tickets, whatever, 20 tickets, whatever, to sell if they want to make money, blah, 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 blah. And a lot of times they'll just be like, yo, dog, I just, honestly, I just want to come and just support whatever and just it's not even I want to get paid, I don't even want to make money or whatever. That's where they look at it, right?
And that's cool.
And they still show up and they'll have enough people and
and even if they only bring their four or five people or whatever, but honestly we got to the point where the artists were making minimum $5 off each ticket.
Yeah, exactly.
So I mean, only five people only gets you $25, but that pays for your food and whatever else.
And I've done a lot of shows where, bro, I made a killing off of pay to play. Making half a stack easy, just off of one run, just easy, just boom, and just putting it out there and just let it, it depends on the artist, though. That's the thing. It depends on the buzz for it. Certain shows would sell off quick. For whatever reason, if you did a match house show, or if you did a, what else? Give me another example. Classified.
Okay, yep.
If you did a classified show, sell off quick, right?
Snack the Ripper, any white rapper from the West,
It's crazy though, man.
But
those guys would always come down. Snack the Ripper and those guys.
That's why I was saying.
When did you guys bring them down? Was you guys?
We did the Canadian Music Week thing that one time, and then it was some crazy shit happened. But yo, connect the dots.
Was your boy out there too?
I don't know who.
What's his name? The same guy we just talked about earlier. Fuck. See, I have a bad memory.
I don't know. Let's not talk about him. If he's not talking. He doesn't sound like he's talkaboutable. So let's
talk aboutable.
Let's talk about Connect the Dot 3. Yeah. So to catch you guys up. So basically, I'll pop the flyer up on the screen now, and now I can make fun of Gutz a little bit.
Yeah.
You see that right there? Okay, guys. So this is when Gutz started sneaking in, and he started taking over the poster, right? Okay. So you see his face on the top, but you know what? Likely so, rightfully so. He earned it. He deserved it, and it was also his birthday. So we piggybacked the event. We made it like really cool for his birthday. We were back at Nocturne, his favorite spot, and it was actually such a sick event. We had such a good time. Let's go over the lineup quick, and we'll go over the winners quick, and we'll keep it moving here so you guys can keep engaged here. If you guys are enjoying it, you know, drop a like or something if you want, or subscribe. This is the new Connect the Dot podcast YouTube channel. We're going to be dropping content as much as possible. Gutz, let them know why I look for shit.
Let them know what?
More about the podcast.
Well, fuck, man. You already said everything, man, about the podcast, man. Like, we're just going to be talking about shit. Like, that's what we're doing.
We're going to talk about Connect the Dot related stuff. We're going to talk about the local music scene. We're going to be launching a website where we can basically start doing like playlists. We can start doing we can start getting the merch out there. We can start basically doing a lot of different stuff. We'll show you guys the content, keep you guys updated on what's going on. And then we were talking about doing some virtual events.
Well, yeah, that's definitely on the table right there, man, because that seems like what's the trend right now. I don't know right now, like, how I feel about this whole virtual thing, you know, and, like, sometimes it's just so weird, you know, it's different.
I agree. I'm kind of not into it. I was thinking about doing, I don't know, we'll talk about what we're going to do next a little bit later, so stay tuned, keep locked in. We're going to go over this lineup first. So what we did here was, this was your birthday
event. So this was my birthday event. So who was on the bill here?
Okay, so on this one, we had, where are we here? All right.
I remember my birthday event. That was a pretty good event. That was a lot of people that came through, man.
What do you remember about it?
I was drinking a lot. I remember. Yeah, it was on my actual birthday too, I think.
Is this the one? The one with DJ Drew Live.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. So this one was actually wild. You're right. The special guest for this one was actually Mark Jordan. Big shout out to Marky Mark.
Mm-hmm.
And we had the usual THC,
mm-hmm.
which includes, you can maybe explain quick about THC.
THC, my nigga Source, Roddy Raw, Mr. Mills, Specz, Ghost, and of course your boy Mike Gutz.
Right, so he said that really smoothly. That's for the that's for the ladies.
That's for the ladies, you know, whatever. Yeah.
So just,
but yeah, you know, we doing our thing right now. Everybody's, you know, doing their thing right now. It's just, you know, it'd be nice if we can all get together and, you know, handle business, but, you know, life gets in the way with shit, you know, and
yeah,
you know what it is, right? So you know, I'm just happy I'm here right now, man. I mean, like, fuck, this is the podcast right now, man.
We're launching.
You know, hit the subscribe button, you know, make sure you do that. It's going to be streaming everywhere. Like, you know, you're going to, you know, hit up the Spotify.
If you're listening to us on Spotify,
yeah,
check us out on YouTube. If you're watching us on YouTube, don't forget we're on Spotify.
We're still building. That's the thing. Like,
this is the first episode.
We're like trying to get used to this whole thing. Like, you know, we're gonna bring guests in too. Like, we don't know if we're gonna bring them in, but
we might put them up on the screen because of COVID.
Tell us who you think. We want you guys to tell us who you think we should interview first.
Who should we bring in?
We wanna know who is like the guy that we should interview first, like the main guy that's gonna, like, you know, launch our shit, launch everything that we're trying to do, that's gonna brand himself as, like, you know, the main person doing shit in the city, like, or pioneer or something.
Let us know what else you guys want to see on the podcast. Let us know what other content you'd like us to see.
Yeah.
We don't have to just do podcasts, but we're gonna start keep it regular. So stay tuned, listen, let us know what topics you want to hear. We're not just going to always talk about Connect the Dot stuff, like the events, and go over the past events and everything, but we wanted to get everybody up to speed and let them know what the hell's up.
Yeah, but
if you've never heard of Connect the Dot before, this will let you know a little bit. If you actually are familiar with Connect the Dot, this will kind of like kind of give you a little bit of bring you back down memory lane and like
they so that one on my birthday, that's the one that Specz won, right?
So that is the one that Specz won. I was just gonna ask you that. Who do you think won that one? Yes, that's the one. Dre Specz crushed.
Yeah, I remember that because Specz, yeah, he bullied his way to win.
So it's funny because if you look up here, this was the like, see that picture?
That's the same
picture that's on the flyer. This flyer. Right? And now this is the one after it. This is two tours after it. Yeah. This picture comes back into play.
Yeah.
And look who got himself sketched in from this event. Because at this event, this is when we decided that we were going to give that person the opportunity to come on tour with us. Because we had been already talking about the tour at this point. The tour was already getting spoken into play. So... now, Dre Specz wins that one. We're at Nocturne. Absolutely killer lineup. The lineup's crazy.
Yo, shout out to Dre Specz, though. No, he killed
it. He absolutely deserved it. And from then, he had been an asset to the squad.
I think that's when, like, basically, I look at Connect the Dot, and I feel like there was a certain turning point.
And this is it.
I think this was it.
Yeah, I agree.
And this is what kind of launched the, like,
well, if you
the
look
tour
at the,
and the...
if you look at the lineup, it's pretty good. The lineup, we had Spidey, we had Swisship Styles, we had the Chameleon, we had Mark
Specter. Yeah, we had some pretty good guys on that
Soul,
show.
Yeah. Dre Specz.
Soul was in the top. I think he was in the top.
Yeah, I think he came second.
Or
I think
like
third
that.
Or something.
Second or third, like, right? I remember. He was up there. He was up for there. Sure. Yeah.
But even like Mo Littles, M.O. Littles, we had Dirty. Oh shit, M.O. Littles. I think this is the one where Mo Littles had a little bit of a stumble, but
I don't want to go too far.
Yeah. Shout out to Mo Littles. Mo Littles is killing it right now.
I remember that actually.
And then we had Skyboy J. It happened to anybody, bro. We had Double R. Oh, I think Double R did well as well.
I think he did too.
Yeah, and then we had Germs and Black Gang, and then we had our. So that was a good one. Again, we had Dre Specz won that one. Go check out Dre Specz's music. We'll leave a link in description as well. We'll leave the link of all the winners. The overall winners from each, just number one. We won't leave all of them, just the number ones from each one. We'll leave them in the description so you guys can check them.
Yeah.
So let's keep it moving so we can keep everything popping. Now, as we get to four, so we had one, which was a one-off event. Two, a one-off event at Nocturne.
Yeah.
Two, one-off event at Whitby at Barney's. Three, another one-off event in Toronto at Nocturne. Now, four wasn't just one event. We did four shows, and it was a mini tour. And this is where things got a little bit more interesting. And looking back into this, as I was doing the research, this is when that mannequin challenge thing was popping.
The mannequin challenge.
Dog, it was so funny. I went back, and do you remember what we did?
Yeah.
At every show, I think it was every single show.
Pull it up.
Okay, I'm gonna play it for you guys, but every single show we did a mannequin challenge.
Yeah.
And we did it like right when it happened, so it was like our videos kind of went a little viral.
Yeah, I remember that shit.
We didn't hit World Star or anything, but we did pretty good numbers on those.
That was some good vibes.
It was good. Take a look, we're gonna show you guys now to watch this quick, a little montage of our mannequin challenge on tour. Yeah. Check it out. Look what we did to these clubs. Check it out.
Beatles in confiscate the money. Fresh girl. Wow. My way.
You sent flowers, but you said you didn't receive. You said you couldn't meet. That girl is a real crowd, please. Small world, all the friends know of me. Young bull living like an old geese. Quick release the cash, watch it fall slowly. Frat girl still trying to get in. Haters mad for whatever reason. Smoke in the air, binge drinking. They lose it when the DJ drops the knee. Getting so gone.
So now you see that, like, that shit's crazy, right? Like, some funny ones, like some are pretty jokes. Like, if you look back at them, you're gonna see like all the different people. Like, you see Vincey Prince, the DJ, you see Curse,
you see. And you know what, for the most part, I think other than Brampton, I think for most of them, they were all, the crowd was like for it. They were all with it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Brampton, they weren't really with it. I think it was like,
I don't remember the Brampton one, but I guess I just watched.
I think, you know, like, there's like, just like the attitude for it. It was just like, fuck you guys.
I liked how like some people were like punching, like pretending to punch people in the face. You had one guy.
Yeah.
It was LIP was like balling up. You had Kenzo with the camera in London. There was like cool ones where like you guys are like standing on stage.
And I went right behind you guys.
And you're like, look, it was actually like, we had some really cool ones.
Yeah, we had some really good ones.
And this one was when we did a tour, and the tour support was actually none other than Five Deuce. Rest in peace to Curse Dre. Curse Dre was like the general.
That's crazy.
And free
rest
halfway.
Rest in peace, Curse Dre.
Rest in peace, Curse, man. That one was crazy, bro. And it's funny.
When that happened, I was like, wow. That's
the craziest thing is how Five Deuce got snuck their way right onto this tour. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
If you look back, you never saw Five Deuce's name in any of the old
shows.
You
were the one that brought, like, yeah. Like,
I did, because Curse and honestly, like, Denver and Halfway, like, these guys.
I knew about those guys, and it's like, yeah, like,
They had nothing to do with money. They didn't buy their way on.
That's the thing. Like, I was just like, wow. Like,
they
I was
really
surprised,
earned
like,
it.
You know?
And honestly, they earned it from another tour that I had done in between that, which was the Dre Specz tour. And Dre bought them on tour. And I was like, man, these guys are what's up. We need this energy on the whole tour. Because you already bring that energy as a host.
Yeah.
And your performance and stuff. But these guys brought, like, that same energy, basically, like, to kind of go along with your energy. You know what I mean?
Like, exactly. And I
complimented
just
what you were bringing.
And I just didn't, it was like one of those ones where it's like, you know, when you brought the idea, I was like, oh, okay. Like, I just, you know, it was a good, like, move by you to, like, you know, bring those guys, right? It's not to say, like, I didn't think to bring them on. It's just.
No.
It's just they were, like.
It's hard to just put somebody on. You can't. It's hard to pick, right?
No, exactly.
And we've always wanted to, but it was like, okay, what, we're just going to put Mike Gutz on?
Yeah,
like,
no.
And to be honest, it's not that you don't deserve that. Of course you do, you know, but.
But why,
again,
what would that do?
It doesn't really help the brand. You're already getting your recognition through doing it.
Listen,
and stuff.
I don't need to, like, you know, be all doing all that. I play my part, right?
That's it.
And that's the whole thing with this. That's what's really, like, led to, like, you know, the success of this whole thing, where it's like, you know, you took the idea and you took it to another level. Like, you took, I said a hot line, you made it a hot song kind of thing, right? Like, you did wonders with it, right? So
appreciate that.
Yeah, man, like, it was proper, right? Like,
yeah, well, it was a combo thing, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So, like you said, you played your part, I played my part. we created a monster, this was a 4-show monster. The first tour, we had 5 deuce on it. We did a show in Oshawa at the Mustache Club, which, if you heard earlier, is my favorite venue.
No.
We did a show in Brampton at Spot One, which was one of the better venues around that area.
Yeah.
Then we went to Gutz's favorite spot, which was Toronto at Nocturne. And yep. Then we went to probably one of the worst venues that we've done, which was the Grinning Gator in London.
Oh, God.
It's a good bar, not really for hip-hop shows, but I guess it could be if it was done the right... It wasn't what we wanted. But anyways, great show, great owner of that bar. The bar owner is great and stuff, like staff was great and everything like that.
Right.
Just not the right layout, per se. We didn't really know what to expect. Anyways, long story short, Oshawa show.
I mean, that was pretty lit.
Oshawa show was amazing. I think one of our better shows on the tour. Let me just double check here. Where are we here?
I think Schizo won that, didn't he?
Let's see. Connect the dot.
It was either Schizo or it was, man. Came out of there.
So, in Oshawa, there was Schizophrenic, Zay's, Subconscious, Ace Pronto, Canadian Fly Guys, Mac, Challenge Accepted, LG, KP and Bones, Big Main, and OC. In Toronto, we had Mark Jordan, Casper the Ghost, OG, Exceed, Dustin Wareham, Shelby GT, New Guy, Rella, Jules, City Streets, LIP, J So Breezy, Leo Davis, Double R, Peak, Jadon, and Fitted Kush. Crazy lineups, eh?
Pretty good.
London. We had Temple Mental, Laura Ledger, Young Prince Beat, Snaps Kush, Last Sesh, K-Mac, Junior Filion, Taddy So Batty, Jux Kane, and Swish Styles. And then in Brampton.
Taddy So Batty.
Yeah, that was her first appearance. No. I don't know if she showed up or not.
I don't know if she was on that one.
She was on the list. I don't know if she showed up. I don't remember, to be honest. So long ago.
On that one.
We're going to find out the winners in a second here.
Right.
Brampton, we had Moss Boss, Jay Terror, White Plague, Saipher Soze, Corridor 200, Dre Specz. How did he sneak on that?
Yeah.
Dirty. He always finds a way.
Yo, this guy.
Dirty.
And talk about me like getting like the over promotion.
I know. Dirty. Dynamic. T Grams, Game Theory, and Scrap Gang.
I feel it's T Grams headline. No, not headline, but like he.
No.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
He was in the contest?
Yeah, I don't know how he didn't win.
Exactly.
But maybe he didn't show up.
I don't know, man.
For all we know, he didn't show up.
No, he was there.
I want to give him his credit. Like, I'm sure he did.
He was there.
But hold on.
He was there with Barrs.
This is the one that we had the finals at Revival.
Is it?
Yeah, this is when Saukrates came in.
Yeah, it is.
So when we did the finals in Revival, this is when we just do one of these. We find out. Connect the dot. Revival. Oh no, that was that one. This is the one. January 26th, 2018.
January 26th, 2018.
That was when we did the finals for the first tour. So Connect the Dot 4, technically.
Yeah.
Our first tour, but Connect the Dot 4. Was 2018. So we started in 2014. We did 3, and then this is our fourth one. Like, this is our fourth. We did the whole tour, so we did four more shows.
Yeah.
And so then 7. This is our fifth show.
No, 6.
Oh, sorry.
No, 1, 7.
2,
7.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7. 8. This is our eighth show.
Yeah.
In total.
Yeah.
So, but which is our first finals.
Mm-hmm.
Like that, where
exactly.
We grabbed the winners. And then we actually brought Saukrates as our main judge, and we also had Adam Bomb, which was the headliner, which was a huge deal. We sold out Revival. Was
that
one
was
of the,
a good show.
That was the craziest show Connect the Dot ever had.
Yeah.
To this day. The best overall show, overall outcome of a show, that was the best to this day.
Absolutely.
I would say.
Absolutely.
Hands down.
Like, I remember being on stage and it being like, I don't know, maybe like just after two, and Atom Bomb's on. Like, he just got on like not too long ago. And it was like, because one of those shows where it was like running a little late because yeah. Socrates, they never chose the winner yet. And
right, yeah, they took like a half hour. Yeah, it was actually, like, we were upstairs, yeah, counting all the fucking. Yeah, oh, yeah,
it took forever.
VIP was a mess that night. That's when I really learned about VIP. Yeah. I was like, yo, I did VIP wrong tonight.
Yeah,
for real. I really did. I did it wrong that night. Yeah, I should have done it differently. I learned that night.
How do you say that?
I should have had security there and VIP passes. I didn't do that, and it got sloppy up there.
For real, eh?
Yeah. We managed it well, though. Because we have a respectable crowd, because we have our community, so there was no drama ever. But it was a bit of a free-for-all.
For real, eh?
Yeah, but then I got it under control. Like, when I went up there, it was under control. I was the main, I was the only person that, like, that was it. It was just because you were busy, obviously.
It was one of those
situations.
You know
what I mean? Yeah, you never even got to really see VIP.
I went up there maybe for twice. A little bit.
Yeah.
Did my thing a little bit, like, but I didn't really enjoy it, you know? But that's the thing, like, these nights, it's like, sometimes they're a blur for me, because I'm just, you know, so busy hosting.
Same with me, you know,
putting, like, everything together. And it's,
I remember random shit.
I can't really, like, sit back and enjoy, you know?
Truth.
Like,
I usually at the front door.
Yeah.
Even when I put somebody on the front door, I'm at the door, because somebody always needs me at the door.
Yeah.
Being a friggin' promoter, you're pretty much a door guy. Even when you have your shit together, and you have someone on the front door, but you're definitely a door guy.
You're the guy.
Like, you are the guy.
Like, you know, like, you're the promoter. Right?
And those promoters that turn their phones off and just enjoy the night, hats off to you guys. I don't know how you guys do it so good, but good job, guys.
Forever.
So, just to kind of, these are the winners. I listed all of the performers for each stop at the last one. I didn't want to take too long to go through each show, but these are the winners that we ended up with for our finals.
Yeah.
So, showcase performers. So, we had Schizophrenic. We had Jux Kane, we had Team OBM, we had Saipher, Soze, Zays, Treetop Entertainment, Laura Ledger, Canadian Fly Guys, LIP, J-So Breezy, Dustin Wareham, and OG Fitted Kush. And that's a stacked lineup.
Yeah.
Schizophrenic, dope. Jux Kane, one of my favorite rappers from London, from Toronto, from London, whatever you want
to
say.
He didn't come to the finals, and neither did Schizo.
But both dope, regardless, you know what I mean? Team OBM, dope. They're one of those guys that they have a lot big following as well. Those are the guys that you kind of hate, like the guys that got the big following, but they're actually pretty dope. They know how to party too.
Yeah.
Shout out to Team OBM. Saipher Soze, absolutely an animal, right?
Well, he was the winner, right?
Well, now you ruined it for the audience.
Spoiler alert. Anyway.
Saipher Soze wins this and ends up meshing his name into this is like Mount Rushmore for Connect the Dot right here.
Yeah,
right now, you know what I mean? How did Gutz get on there? Yeah,
stop this.
No, I'm just joking,
where's your face?
Oh, I don't want to be. I'm like a face for radio. So shout out to my Spotify people.
Yeah, exactly.
The Spotify people are my people. The YouTube people are your people.
Yeah, there you go.
So we had all these cats here stacked lineup. Like I said, Treetop Entertainment. That's Casper Marcus and them. We had Zays, who's absolutely sick, Nino Nickel representative, Laura Ledger, who's actually a dope female MC, made
her
way to the top.
I don't think she was there.
I'm not sure, but she probably was because she's pretty dope and she usually
I don't think she was there, man. I don't think she was there.
I think she was there.
I don't think she was there.
I think she was there.
I would have remembered Laura Ledger. I remember her at
the London show. Yeah.
But I don't remember at the revival show.
She might not have came.
I don't think she came.
Canadian Fly Guys. Did they come? I don't know.
I think so.
Nibs Nizama?
I think, that's what I'm saying. I think they did. I think they did.
I know LIP did. I know J-So Breezy did.
Mm-hmm.
Dustin Wareham did.
Mm-hmm.
And OG, I believe, did too. OG
yeah. I feel OG did, yeah.
He showed up late, actually, but he usually does.
Yeah.
Anyways, so the winner of that ended up obviously being Saipher Soze. Second place being, I believe it was J-So Breezy.
Socks judge that, right?
Yes.
Socks and Atom Bomb?
I don't know if Atom Bomb was a judge. So much as I think it was Socrates' wife and we had somebody else there. Let me see here.
I wonder who. I swear it was Socks and Bomb.
Oh, by the way, so we had Blacka Da Don perform. who yep. absolutely smashed it.
I remember
he had like some cool like light up jacket, I think it was, and light up shoes or something. Yep. It was sick. Kid Daniels absolutely crushed it, and then our homie Dre Specz, who won himself a slot there from before. I don't know how he snuck his way into another show. I don't think he was supposed to be meant as listed as a competitor at the other show. He was just a
I think he just was just performing and just, but, just put his name there. Because, yeah.
Main judge was Saukrates. Special guest performances. And then it doesn't say anything else.
Don't know. It doesn't say about the judges?
No. It just says Saukrates. I think I was a judge.
Maybe. Or maybe I wasn't.
You might have been a judge, actually.
I could
have. I think you might have been. I hope so. Because you're pretty... I like when you're a judge because you actually give it a
You know what, though? Opinion. Judging sometimes, it's hard sometimes.
I know, because it's like opinionated, you mean?
Yeah, it's like, I don't like being that critic guy, like, yo, you know,
oh, blah, you should blah, do blah. This.
And like, yeah, your Spart schemes. And the, like, you know, I did it for like, I remember when I judged the, what was it, Got Barrs or whatever, the one that Fatah was doing.
Not sure.
Yeah.
Sounds like some whack shit to me. No, I'm just kidding.
No, I'm kidding. No, it was all right, totally man. It was dope.
Joking, bro.
No, it was dope. But anyways,
back to this quick. Judging, you're saying it's hit or miss. Like, sometimes it's fun, sometimes it's kind of whack. You kind of like sitting in a weird position.
Yeah,
I've done it a bunch of times, and I know what you're saying, but I enjoy doing it because I just get my honest opinion. Yeah. And I feel like we're the type of people that'll just be like, we kind of know what sounds good, and we know kind of what sounds like shit. But,
yeah, exactly.
So, moving on, just to kind of keep everybody kind of engaged here, you know what I mean? Yeah. Like, so we went from that, we did the finals, we picked the finals, we talked about all the performers, we talked about the winner, Saipher Soze, who absolutely crushed it, etched his way into the Mount Rushmore. Now we're on to Mount Rushmore. So Mount Rushmore is our last series that we did up to date. So to get you guys up to date, this is the last series, and then we'll move on to what's next, and then we'll get you guys out of here so you guys can continue on with your day. Whether you're in your car listening, at home watching, whatever it is, thank you for watching. If you are still watching, just make sure you smash the like button. Comment something if you are watching, because like, if you are watching up until now and you've listened to every single thing up until now, you're the type of people that we want to know are actually watching this stuff for us to even make this material. You know what I mean? Like, should we keep making this? Like, if we should, like, just comment right now in the comments for us if you can.
Hit that subscribe button.
Maybe comment hashtag connect the dot. You know what I mean? Just do that for me in the comments.
Tag an artist. Tag an artist that we should be paying attention to.
Share the video if you can for us. You know what I mean? Share it on your Facebook.
We're gonna be blasting, you know, we're gonna be putting a lot of content on here. And
we also want to put artists on, like we were saying, the playlists, and we want to do...
we're gonna be talking about, you know, some shit.
But we'll get into what's next. So let's talk about Mount Rushmore here. Yeah. I don't know why I keep calling it that, but Connect the Dots series. We got
Mount Rushmore.
It's kind of cool, right?
That's a big statement, though.
Yeah. I like it. Yeah. Well, think about it. Kid Daniels. He's pretty dope. He's still actually relevant. He's still dropping music.
But on the Mount Rushmore of Connect the Dot? Like,
weathers out as you get to the sides.
What are you saying?
Maybe at, like, the far rights and lefts. Like, they can kind of...
Yeah? Is that what you think? Is that what you think right
now? Oh, no. Oh, wait. Oh, that's you. My bad. Oh,
stop this, man.
No, I'm just kidding. No, but, you know what I'm saying, bro. Like, it's pretty good. Like, it's pretty... It kind of shows old school, new school. It shows a little bit of everything, right?
For sure.
But I think, like, the newest one that we drop, especially with the gap now in between this one and, like, now, I think it's going to be crazy. But getting into this one, so we did about six shows. Seven shows, including the finals. The finals was on a yacht party.
We didn't do Hamilton.
No, we didn't do Hamilton. That's why I said six.
Yeah.
And then the seventh one would be the finals, which would be on the yacht.
We did Oakville?
Yeah, man. We did Oakville, bro.
Yeah?
Chris Hewlett. Oh, okay. Yeah, it was kind of empty, but it was like...
It was alright.
It was a cool show.
Actually, it was a pretty good show. It wasn't empty. It was alright.
It was okay.
It wasn't great.
It wasn't the best one I meant to run. No, let's just say that,
it was far.
But no, North Bay was far.
I didn't go to Ottawa.
North Bay was crazy.
Yeah, North Bay was pretty crazy.
Ottawa was...
That was a crazy drive. I remember that drive.
North Bay was like... We went from... It was like nice day in the city. As soon as you got up north, all of a sudden, blizzard. Bam. Blizzard. Hit the blizzard.
I remember driving like 60 miles per hour. And it was just... No, just... Nothing but snow. I feel like I'm going uphill. It was crazy.
Yo, same. I felt like we were going to the mountains.
Yeah.
It was kind of
It was kind of surreal still.
Yeah. But I remember who picked up the show again? It was Chris Goslin. Chris Goslin actually picked up the show out there. He brought us to the Summit, I believe it was called. And he treated us to like a nice hotel and stuff. He took care of us and stuff like that. He was really on point. Really cool guy. And actually, he did a good job promoting the thing. Like for the place that we were in, I was kind of expecting...
That was a pretty cool place.
Yeah, there was at least like almost 200 people.
Yeah, that was a pretty good place.
Nice little venue. Like, the venue was a little too big, but they made it where like the dance floor was like kind of right in the center.
I liked the colors.
Yeah, it was good. It was nice.
It was really bright.
So we can go into it a bit. So I remember North Bay. I mean, I guess we could go into the whole lineup, right? Or should we just talk about the winners? Let's just talk about the winners.
Yeah.
So I remember North Bay, we had Jay Downs was our winner.
Yeah.
So he was the guy. Jay Downs is sick.
Yeah.
So he's blind.
I remember Jay Downs.
He's blind guy.
Shout out to Jay Downs.
But he can rap, he can sing, the guy makes beats, he's a producer, just absolutely talented as hell.
For sure.
And then basically from, there was him, and Bobo was second place.
Bobo.
What was it?
Socrates, Bobo killed it.
Socrates kept saying something
to Bobo. Yeah, because I told him to wheel it back.
He went on stage Bobo. And he was like, yo, Bobo. You remind me of my boy, Bobo Baggins or something. Like,
Bobo.
He kept saying some weird shit to him.
I can't remember. That was jokes.
And then I remember third place was the homie Tactics. And Tactics was dope. He was a fire spitter. Yeah. And I remember he got the crowd audience. I guess he probably sold the most tickets because I know he sold the most tickets on Connected Out on the Yacht.
For real.
So the guy's got supporters. So shout out to Tactics.
All the way from North Bay. That's crazy.
He's sick, though. Like, he's a good dude. Guy hunts and shit. Like, yeah, he's from North Bay, right? Buddy hunts. He raps. He does this. He's a good dude. He's a guy, though. He's cool, man. Like, I like him. I like people like that, man.
Yeah, for sure. Like, you know, like,
live
people
life,
like, just... You know, they have that following, and like, you know, like he's doing his thing. Like, that's like
it's
his
like whatever passion. He does, though, you can tell he gives it. Like,
yeah, you know that's crazy. You so know, like good. The fact like, that people like can support him like that.
True,
you know?
And true.
Like,
and not know? A lot of people do, but yeah,
a lot of people can
it's
do
very
that.
Easy to spend $10 to support a guy, and
straight up,
download his music or whatever.
Straight up, man.
So that was North Bay. It was a pretty dope show.
Yeah.
Then we went to Newmarket. We were at Stellar Hall. That's like the usual.
Yeah.
It's always meh at Stellar Hall, but you know, honestly, I'm not a big fan. I mean, I did some damage in Newmarket. We did some good shows out there. There is a music scene out there. They just don't have venues, like good supportive venues, and Stellar Hall is a nice venue, and the venue owner's great. Like no diss on them.
Yeah.
It's just not the right spot for a hip hop show. You know what I mean?
Yeah, for sure.
Great guy, great owner, great venue for if you want to get married or have like a fucking prom night or something. But Newmarket, I believe we had Timo BM had to have been the winner, right? No,
I think so.
What do we have?
I think it was OBM that won that.
Had to have been them. It had to be Team OBM.
Or was
it? Maybe they had already advanced.
I don't even know.
We're going to find out today.
I don't even remember that show.
Me neither.
I really don't even remember that show.
I just remembered. This show got flipped. This was a Danny special. This was a flipped last minute, didn't have the venue anymore, and we went to the Lions fucking thing. The Lions fucking squirking fucking thing.
What?
Oh, we did do it at Stellar Hall.
Yeah, we did it at Stellar Hall.
We did do it. We had the little back room, and it was shit. It was sus. You remember the little back room we
had? That was bullshit. I don't.
Do you remember that? Yeah, we did do it there. And Anthony Champion was there, and the owner was like, because I had just done Anthony's blow tour, so we had done Stellar Hall, and Anthony, like, I guess tore the roof. We did 300 people in there for Anthony's show. It was crazy.
Yeah.
And Anthony was jumping all over everything. So when the owner seen Anthony at the Newmarket show, he goes, yeah, you guys should have seen it last time Dan was here. There was this little guy jumping all over the furniture, and he was body surfing, and Anthony's there. He's like, yeah, that was me. And he's like, that wasn't you. And he's like, oh, yeah, watch tonight.
Oh, my God.
Of course, Anthony goes crazy. But no, yeah, that was a sus. No, it was a good show, though. It was just weird. The venue was just weird.
It was all right.
So anyways, the winner, though, of Newmarket, somehow the first place is deleted from the event page. So I don't know what happened, but first place, it must have been Team OBM.
You still fuck with those guys?
Yeah, but it might have been because they asked me to delete it because they're no longer Team OBM or something.
Oh, yeah?
I don't know, man. Anyways, Vocal Legend. And he stood out to me too. He's dope, Vocal Legend.
Okay.
And then we had It's D-Lo. Like, Newmarket's a wash. Can we just say that? Then we go to Oakville.
Who was in Oakville?
Oakville, we had two came in first place. TU.
Oh, yeah, two was alright.
Yeah, he was sick.
Yeah, okay.
We had Fonte, who I believe was doped as well.
Okay.
And then we had Philly Mafia, who's obviously dope.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Philly's
yeah,
sick.
Yeah. He was out there. Yeah, yeah, he was out there.
He came kind of solo dolo, like yeah, four or five
yeah,
people
yeah,
deep.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I remember.
And just kind of cooled it. Yeah, he came yeah. and just ripped his shit, man. He's dope.
I actually dropped him by the ends after.
No way. And yeah. he speaks French and shit too. And yeah, he's like, he's dope, man.
Yeah.
Shout out to Philly. Shout out to Vontae. Shout out to Two. Shout out to yeah. D-Lo. Shout out to Vocal Legend Jordan.
That's some tactics.
Moving on to London. What's that?
That's some good spitters on Oakville.
Oh, 100%.
Actually, it kind of surprised me. But they it just didn't have a lot of people.
But that's the thing. They need people like us to come there and do regular shows where they actually are good, talented people coming there and actually have people that can get the word out to the people in that area. Like that's
I went to that show out there and Fatsa was running the event. And it was a sick show. Like, nice. He did it proper. Like, yeah. I can't remember, it was probably like one of my last shows I did. Now right. I think about it, before like whole COVID shit shut down everything, right?
I think it's a good area, bro. I just think it needs to be tapped into the right way.
Yeah.
I don't think we necessarily did tap into the right way, but at least we did something, right?
For sure.
Then we moved on to London, and London, that was one of the best shows on the tour. That we were at Old East 765 Bar. Shout out to them. They're super supportive of local hip hop, and they're really dope people. The owner and stuff. The venue was
that
great.
That was the one that Lola won.
Lola won that one, yep. And she also sold hella amount of tickets.
And
that's not why she won it. And then also Axel Rosa, rest in peace to Axel Rosa.
For sure.
He also was pumping that like crazy. We had lots of people out there, Axel Rosa, man. And then we also had Nigga Wanna. Yeah.
R.I.P. to Axel Rosa.
R.I.P. Yeah, man.
That's a hard one. That was a hard one.
Straight up, bro. We've had a lot of really hard losses over the years.
You know, and
if you guys want to check out some of Axel's stuff, we should leave that in the description.
Yeah, for sure, man.
So there's got to be a link.
There's a lot of things, you know, that are gonna be happening soon, and you know, you gotta just stay tapped in, right? I don't want to really like spill the beans with all that, right? But like, you know, Axel's name's gonna live on, you know.
For sure. And
it's sad. It's just thinking about it, just like really, like you know. It's like what hurts is that I was supposed to like link with this guy.
Yeah.
Probably during like the winter months, like because like, you know, the way like my work schedule is and everything, like the way I could do it is like only during like the later part of like December, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right? Like so, I was gonna go check him and like maybe like you know spend a couple days up there, and then when I found out what happened, like you know it was at the beginning of like December, I was like, man,
bro, actually,
just made me think. I was like, frig, yo, like. Like life is so like precious, bro. Like you gotta like you're not promised tomorrow, and it's like, you know, it cheeses me because, you know, for those who don't know, like Axel like engineered G-Notes, so
okay,
like he like me and him were like in the lab all summer, like just like putting in that work, whatever, and like getting to know him as a person. It was like. Man, like this guy, you know, he's a solid dude. Like, there's certain people like you get a vibe off of them.
Yeah.
Like, you know, when you're like chill with a person, you get a vibe off of them, and you like realize, like, yo, this guy's a real guy. Like,
yeah.
I feel like I can, like, you know, tell him my inner shit and, like, he's listening.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Like, you could trust him immediately.
Like, he's one of those
harmless kind of person. Yeah.
No ill will. And that's the vibe I got off of working with Axel. And,
Same,
you know, like, I was excited, like, to, like, let him hear more of my shit. Like,
you know what's crazy though is like, and it's crazy. You can see the ripple effect people have on people. Like when you see people posting about him and stuff. Now that he is passed away and stuff like that, but it's just crazy because everyone had their own little experience with him. And like, it's cool when you have that energy and you put it out there and people can recognize it. And it being genuine and being positive and being that supportive person. It really goes a long way. And he was the type of guy, because like I know personally, like I didn't know him from a hole in the wall.
Yeah.
And he was all over anything that I was posting.
For sure.
And it's because of
he respected you for sure, man.
Out of a bunch of different people and stuff like that I guess put him on to me or whatever, and then me talking with him as soon as he linked me. And you know me, I'm like pretty easy to work with. Like, you hit me up, like, let's go. What do you want to do? Oh, you want to work? Okay, let's go. What's up?
Yeah,
let's go.
Yeah,
I'm pretty easy to work with, to be honest. And he hit me up, and I was like, okay, let's go. What do you want to do? Oh, I want to do this. I want to put this person on. I want to put it this way. Can we label it this way? Can you write it? Can you switch it this way? Can you change? Yeah, no problem. What do you need? And constantly, he's, oh, I'm so sorry. Like, I don't mean to bother you. Like, no problem, bro. And he's like, you know, with the video stuff, he's like constantly like messaging me, oh, good job on this. Good job. Oh, can you teach me this? Can you teach me that?
And
always reaching, and always trying any single time he ever reached out to me, I never wanted a dollar from him. I didn't want nothing like that. And to be honest, when it came to the connect the dot thing, finally, it was an opportunity for us to actually do business together. Because everything before that was just him supporting me,
right,
and asking me and hitting me up and inboxing and us just communicating online and whatever else. And then when it was time to actually do business, buddy was so on point, super on point, hitting me up. Oh, I'll e-transfer you before, and I'm like, oh, chill, like, don't worry, I'm not in no rush. Like, you can pay me the day of or whatever. Yeah. Or, and he was like, no, I'm gonna e-transfer. I'm gonna make sure it gets to you, and you know, this kind of thing. And I'm like, okay, well, you can make this, and he made money off that, and Lola also made a lot of money off that, and it was dope. But anyways.
Yeah, that was dope.
Rest in peace to Axel.
Rest in peace.
You guys already saw. While we're talking, we wanted to show you guys a little bit of a slideshow. So I put a slideshow up while we were talking about Axel. I just thought of that while we were talking about Axel. So that's a little slideshow. Like I said, we're gonna put a link in the bottom. Go take a look at it. I think there's even like a Kickstarter, GoFundMe, or something like that up there. Some way that you can actually support Axel's music. We are gonna get the link. We're gonna put it in the description, and we're gonna say support Axel here, so we'll figure that out after. I know his wife has something going on, or there's other stuff.
I think they had something.
Okay.
I think at the time, we'll figure out a way to support him.
Even if it's to purchase music, or it's to even just stream his stuff.
I know that there's gonna be a lot of things coming out
for sure, and we'll leave further links. But for this episode, when it comes out, we'll put something. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah, for sure.
But shout out to Axel. We'll keep it moving here. So. Lola came first, Nicawana came in second, who also is crazy, like a talented person.
Yeah.
Guys fighting so much like adversity and still able to put out music and still trying to keep it positive and
must be
tough as hell, especially during COVID, man. Shout out to Nicawana, stay strong, bro. Shout out to Nicawana, bro.
For sure.
Typo, he was dope, really cool guy. He was pretty talented artist. Temple Mental, we brought him back. For those that don't know, Temple Mental, he actually won and was supposed to be part of a previous finals, but wasn't able to make it.
The one at Revival.
Because of, the one at Revival.
Was it the one at Revival?
Yeah, it was. Yep.
Yeah.
He was supposed to be part of a killer show. And I felt so bad for the guy because he went through some family stuff and everything like that. And you know, he had hit me up, and I was like, of course, you know, 100%, and I brought up the Gutz. Gutz was no questions. So we gave him a shot at on the yacht right away. We just put him right to the finals. And shout out to Temple Mental. He came through.
Yeah, for sure.
Did he come through? Did Temple even go? I don't think he did.
Wasn't it the London show?
No, he was supposed to go to the. He was supposed to go to the yacht.
He went to the yacht.
Did he go?
Did he go?
I don't remember seeing him.
I'm not even sure.
I know Lola came.
Yeah.
I don't think Nigawana came. I think Typo came.
Typo did come.
So then in Toronto, we also had Young Stitch. We had Tony Ranks, and we had Young Drama from Toronto.
Mm-hmm.
That was the Revival show. And then from Ottawa, we had King Khan, we had Ricochet, and we had Sin. And I don't think...
I think there was two Ottawa cats that came.
I think it was Sin that came.
And
Ricochet didn't come. Yeah, oh, King Khan came and Sin came.
Okay.
Sin was the other cat from Ottawa who showed up by himself, I think, or like with one other guy.
Yeah.
So going into the finals, guys, basically that was the winners for those previous showcases we talked about. Then we went to the finals, Connect the Dot on a Yacht, and connected the yacht.
That's crazy.
Connected on a Yacht was one of the other crazy events. Like I say, Revival is our best event because overall it was just like such a sick venue, and it's an iconic venue.
Yeah.
A lot of cool stuff happened. It was the first time we had Sox involved and Adam Bomb. It was like an elevation. Like, we leveled up there.
That was the turning point. That was
was the level up.
That was the level
and
up.
This was us continuing to that bar, keeping the bar high.
Yeah.
And then the yacht was for us to level up a little bit more, in a sense, or at least keep it the same as Revival. And I think we brought Organik.
When you brought that idea to me, I like was like, what the fuck is this guy thinking? Like, what are you thinking right now? Like, I didn't know. I wasn't fully sold. I won't lie. I wasn't fully sold with the idea.
I hate that flyer. So the flyer you guys just saw, that was the worst flyer.
Yeah.
I don't know how anybody put the green sold, light on the flyer.
I wasn't sold with the idea because of the because of the timing. And I felt like, I don't know, maybe there was like, maybe there's like, I don't know, just that sense of like, I didn't want to rush like bullshit, you know what I mean?
Right.
Like, I just didn't want to like, you know, do something just for the sake of doing it. So, I don't know. I wasn't really like with the idea at
first. Well, to be honest, that was actually a rough point too, because remember, that like a lot of stuff happened with you in your personal
life. Yeah,
and
sure.
That's what kind of threw that whole thing a little bit sideways.
Yeah.
But to be honest, we pulled it off so well.
We did.
And we had such a sick show.
It was a great show.
It was something like everyone that was part of it always remember.
It was different. It was unique.
So different.
Because it was like, you know, when we actually did it, and then like thinking back, you're like, wow, like this was like...
I was so scared at first, because when I first got to the yacht, and everything was actually really weird at first. Like,
yeah.
There wasn't that many people there at first. Like, there was a decent little lineup at first, but it was like, wasn't getting bigger. I was a little worried. And then the lineup started getting bigger and bigger, and I was like, oh, thank God. Like, we're going to be okay.
Got a little, like,
But we barely broke even. We didn't even break even. We lost money. But you know what?
But I mean, it was a good, thing. It was a good,
good, good,
it was
event.
A good experience, man. Great I mean, experience. You can't even say that, like, you know,
no.
Like,
yeah,
it wasn't dope. Like, it was like, you know,
that's the cool part of the event was having Saukrates on the boat. We had Organik finally as a judge, which is something I wanted to bring in a long time ago. So that was finally able to happen.
That was elevation right there.
And it was cool to be able to show our community that we've built over the years to Organik, to Saukrates, to Atom Bomb, to these other people, right?
Yeah.
And there was a lot of other people on the boat. And, you know, even more people would have been on the boat if it would have been other circumstances. And to be honest, I'm excited because... I mean, that pretty much wraps up. That catches everybody pretty much right up to date on all the stuff connected that we've done.
Yeah.
After that, we've been on a hiatus, coronavirus, pandemic, all this bullshit.
Yeah.
We're trying to think of different ways to bring it back into play. And this is us kind of kickstarting it right now.
Yeah, exactly.
Podcast, we're sitting here. That's first step. YouTube channel.
That's what we're trying to do right now. We're trying to, like, you know, get some ideas going, you know. I got some things I want to do. I'm sure, you know, Barker's got some things you want to do.
100%.
You know, I mean, like, there's some shit that, like, you know, we definitely, like, you know, want to kickstart now with the whole series now.
That's it. So first things first is the podcast. We started that. We launched that. I think what we need to do, obviously, with the website, right? Like we were saying, launch the website, launch the YouTube, launch with the merch. We have tons of, like, I haven't really been pushing the merch as much, obviously, because like, I mean, we're all on hiatus. Like, people don't really have money right now. I'm not trying to be that guy that's like, oh, give me your money, because realistically, the merch is more about the community. It's a brand, it's a label. It's like, yo, who's repping the squad, who's repping the right, like, this is it connect the dots,
for sure,
right?
For sure.
So it's like, we want to launch the merch again. We want to get it out there. I have so many designs. Like, I'm telling you, I have like over 200 designs.
Well, I mean, then that's what we're gonna do.
Right? And then we've got like, so boom, we're gonna launch the podcast. We're gonna launch the merch. We're talking about doing the Spotify playlist, the Connect the Dot monthly Spotify playlist.
Yeah.
Where we gather. I kind of want to go through those names we just talked about, all those different names.
Mm-hmm.
I kind of want to go through and touch base with the winners, especially. And kind of tap in there and start there.
Well, I mean, that's definitely a start, but you know, I think you got to give the opportunity also too for people who want to send music or want to send like content.
That's why we should do two playlists.
And then that's what I mean. Like, we need to, like, 100%. You know,
we should do two. I think also, I was thinking about compilation CD, but that's old, so now everyone does playlist, right?
Yeah, for sure.
So I was thinking, like, we could do something where those artists you're talking about, they make us a single for the playlist,
right?
And we upload it onto our playlist.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I mean, that could work.
And
for
they
sure.
can put it on their own playlist too or whatever, but like, it's like kind of something like that. But I think like the playlist is a cool way to start, like, just kind of filtering it, so we'll drive traffic to the website through the podcast and through social media and through all the artists pumping it, and then that will in turn get the playlist popping, and then the playlist gets, you know, all the artists, they make money off that, right? Yeah, because we're adding them to our playlist, so it means they make money. We're just pushing traffic their way, right?
For sure. So absolutely.
And in turn, also, we're working out brand deals with artists. So, for instance, I've got, like, obviously the Saukrates collaboration's been around for a while. Mm-hmm. The Legend Atom Bomb stuff. We have the Villain merch. We have the Gut Time, or what was the
Gut Check Time?
The Gut Check Time. But we had another one. What was the
Gut Time?
No, it wasn't the Gut Time. I'm an idiot.
What was the Gut Check Time?
Well, the Gut Check Time you already
had. I don't even know.
There was another one we had. I don't think it was Gut Check.
Fuck. I don't even know, man.
Anyways, we're going to have to work on that.
We have to talk about that.
Work in progress. Sure. Yo, what do you guys think for the Guts line? Let us know in the comments.
Yo, I haven't thought about that shit. So, but yo, I have my own custom sweaters, though. Like,
right.
Shit, am I allowed to plug?
Of course. Of course. Well, not.
No, I'm just kidding. But yeah, no, I have my own custom sweaters that I'm doing right now. You know, I'm gonna show you a clip. I'll run the clip right there. You know, but yeah, it's stitched. You know, it's my own Scarborough line right now. I'm just getting started, to be honest with you. But like, yeah, hit me up. You know, custom Mike Guts logo. You know, we have the Wee Beats logo. We have everything stitched. You know, it's the custom brand right now.
Nice.
You know, hit me up on the inbox. You know, I'll let you
link
know what's good.
Link in the description again.
You know, link in the description. All that shit. Like, you know. Make sure that you follow me on the Instagrams at The Real Mike Guts, or at The Mike Guts Official. That's the artist page. You know, all my music, all my content's there. Mm-hmm. But yeah, man, like we gotta get it popping, man.
So
like,
so the merch is one thing.
That's what I was saying. Like, doggy, like, I'm the same. It's gonna be like a connect the dot thing. Like, you know what I mean? Like, you know, like, we got like all this shit, like, you know, all this merch and everything that we're rocking.
This stuff right here is the newer kind of stuff. It's actually printed right on.
Yeah.
Not no vinyl stuff. That's the old
vinyl
stuff. We've been elevating the merch from the beginning.
Like, we're gonna get the merch elevated to another level. You know,
it's gonna be crazy.
We just need to find.
It's gonna be crazy.
We just need to find the right.
Crazy.
Yeah.
But no, what I was gonna say though, after the merch, right? So that's one thing that's gonna be dope with the Connect the Dot site and the new stuff. But when it comes to the events and stuff like that, so. One event idea that I have right now is basically I want to bring artists to Vancouver. I know normally we're in Toronto, but like
right.
I said, our whole idea, like after this right here, our next idea before the pandemic and everything like that, what we were gearing up to do was tour Canada.
That
was the goal.
I remember we were talking about
it was going to happen. I spoke to everybody. It was already on the calendar.
Yeah,
that's how crazy it was.
That was the levels that we were trying to get on.
I don't know if Guts was going to be able to come on the full tour. That's what we had talked about, but we were going to try to get you on as much as possible. I remember that. And I think we were going to try to do a stretch for 2 weeks, and you were going to maybe do like a vacation thing or something. I remember we talked about that, but you were like, I don't know if I can do it. And it's a lot, right?
Yeah.
To do the Canada
I remember thing. Yeah, and you know what, like it was on the conversations and
for sure, like, very yeah. close though, like yeah. To be honest, and so now I'm thinking let's go to Vancouver because I've been there recently and I made some business relationships and stuff like that. I have some good contacts out there. I want to collaborate with a company out there, and basically what I want to do is like a listening party on this houseboat.
For real.
Like the houseboat is sick. So like you can have some people down inside the houseboat having drinks and do like a nice listening party for an artist down there while simultaneously doing a listening party up on the top deck. Or you could do like just one listening party all at once or something like that. Like even the people on the top deck, they're still listening to the same thing the people on the bottom are. And you go through, but like you can't have too many artists. So I'm thinking like six is a good number. It would be long, but it would be dope, you know what I mean? Like it'd be a full like event, like, you know, that would happen. And there would be six artists and then have like four industry cats. So like myself being like a director or whatever, but like maybe a producer, maybe some other cats, right?
Like I'm falling back.
Yeah. And then do it on the houseboat out there, do like a cool experience, like a Vancouver experience. I want to bring cats from Toronto, maybe from just different provinces.
Yeah.
Bring them all together and just do something different, film the whole thing. We can release it on the YouTube channel.
It's just like a party on a boat.
Listening party on a boat. We'll have some constructive criticism. Like people can kind of sneak peek some music. there'll be food, it'll be catered for yeah, sure. Yeah. There'll be drinks, you know what I mean? Yeah, like, for sure. Yeah, like a nice little event, for sure. Right?
Yeah.
And to be honest, it's a houseboat, so a couple people can sleep there if they want, whatever.
For
whatever.
Real.
But,
for real.
It's just an idea that I have. But like, that's just like one unique idea I'm thinking of, because that could follow COVID protocols, right?
Absolutely.
Outdoor, you're on a boat, there's only 10 people.
I mean, I think that that's where. I think a lot of the talks is right now. It's like they're going to do restaurants on the boats.
What about the Saipher idea? I was thinking we bring like a Rhapsody the Basement type style back. Instead of doing performances, like we were talking about doing yeah. like a virtual performance tour where we set up like venues in different cities across the country. Artists come to the venue, they do performances on camera, we put it, upload it, and then people can vote online. But I don't know, like I'm cool with it if we want to do it, if that's what people want to do, like let's do
it. I mean, yeah, I mean,
but like
it is what it is. It's like we can sit here and we can like, you know, and figure out like, you know, what event would be best, or what event would be like, you know, what kind of things we could do. It's just at the end of the day, it's like we want to know what you guys think. We want to know what the artists want to do. What are the trends with this whole
like do you want to
know? Don't you think like the whole scene is different now? Where
it is,
it's like
it's just an online.
It makes it harder to like maneuver. And I think like
it's weird, bro. It's
but
weird.
I think the summer.
And there's like cyber bullshit going on, bro.
I think the summer though, I think there's ways to do it, but you just gotta be like, I don't know, you just gotta be willing to do it. You gotta be willing to like kinda like, I guess, break rules and
I think parameters. Creating content like this and stuff like that is kinda what you have to do.
Because COVID right now is kinda just fucking up progress for a lot of things, right? Like
you can't really. For some people, I always say this, like I've been saying this a lot lately, is like the hustlers are making bank right now, and like the 9-to-5ers aren't. The 9-to-5ers are struggling, and it sucks to see it, but the hustlers are thriving, man. Like the hustlers are hustling, man, and there's just a lot of money out there to be made in different ways, and people are starting to realize it and open their eyes. Like I've started 2 new business ventures just being on COVID, like
yeah,
being
for real.
Pandemic and stuff. Nothing that like is necessarily going to, you know, put me on retirement or something like that, but like, you know, just doing different things, trying to adapt to what's going on right now. So I think that's really a big part of what we have to do with Connect the Dot, is just kind of like adapt with what's going
on. For sure.
So that's why we got to figure out a good format. So are we going to do the performance stuff and do contest winners in each city? They get prizes in each city and do it.
Well, I don't think going to each city.
No, not that we would go to each city, but like we would set up venues, set up film crew in each city. I could go. Me and you could go. We don't even both have to go. I could go. Like me and my film crew go.
Yeah.
And that's it. We don't even need a DJ, bro.
Yeah. For sure.
This is the thing is the thing that I don't like about that idea is that, and now they're saying that you can have 50 people in a venue, right? Mm-hmm. But like let's say we go and book it. And then all of a sudden they're like, oh no, you can only have 10 people in the venue, right? Then we're screwed. So why would we even book it? Like, it's so dumb to even book something.
Exactly.
Right now. We have to wait until the coast is clear on a full out event.
Yeah.
So right now it's either we really have 2 choices. And I don't think it makes sense to do both, because then we're just overworking to get stupid amounts of content.
I mean,
we either do the Rhapsody the Basement style, where we bring artists, let's say 6 artists from each city. The best artists from each city. Maybe we do a voting online or something where they have to vote online to get the best 6, or we just choose 6 or whatever it is, right?
Whatever.
And they all cipher at a studio that we choose from that city. They all go, they write a 16, whatever, to a certain beat maybe, or they have their own thing, whatever we decide. Boom, they all go there, they do a cipher thing, we post that, we have a video, we make it sick, and then we do an online vote and a judging panel. Our judges on our end will pick the top 2, and then we'll do a fan choice just like we did before, right? Keep it the same style like that or whatever, so that we have some familiarity or whatever.
Yeah, for sure.
And then maybe in the finals we could do a something different, because maybe by then maybe we can now bring them and do a performance contest thing, or maybe we by then COVID's like let up a little bit more or something, you know what I mean? But whatever, what do you guys think we should do? Where do you think we should go with it? Those are a couple options.
Yeah,
we're gonna have to figure it out. We're not gonna figure it out right now.
I mean
we need your guys help.
there's a lot of things that I'm not gonna say right now on camera and shit, because you know it's one of those ones you want to just keep hushing, you know, you don't want to like you know, leak, make a leak in this, everything. Whatever. But, mm-hmm. I mean, at the end of the day, like, yeah, there's so many options, like, that you can do. Like you said, hustlers are hustling right now. Like, everybody's, like, doing their thing right now. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's, it is right now. The name of the game, you have to survive in this society right now, so.
So what else do you think next for Connect the Dot?
It all really depends on what our future plans are. And that really depends on you and I, what yeah. we want to do, because no one else is doing it. Like, I see a lot of people right now, they're trying, right? I see people doing IG series,
yeah.
you know, some, like, you know, online shit, like doing online concerts. Like, what's your take on the online concerts? Like, you,
I'm just not a big fan of it. I just don't think if I was an artist, I would enjoy doing the online concert. I think for me, I'd rather do like something like, I think even right now, like, you know how I used to do the music video contest?
Yeah.
I think even running one of those right now would be smart, you know? Like, yeah. even doing a Connect the Dot one would be cool. Like a music video contest where I give everybody like discounted music video. We just do like quick one location videos, but like dope little ones, whatever.
Yeah.
And then we, like, you get judged on the song and the video, you know what I mean, or something like that. I even like the idea of doing, like, it's not always just about me, right? Like, I don't even have to be the guy that does the videos. Give me five video directors, different guys.
I would love to do like a Connect the Dot video, like,
yeah, like, and I don't need to be in it. It doesn't need to be, I don't even want it to be about me. Like, just something cool.
It would have been like, sick. You know what pisses me off? Like, going back to the red carpet treatment, I would have done a video edition. I would have done a video or a director's edition.
Yeah, where it's the different, like, directors against, like, not against each other, but like a top 25 even.
Or
a contest, like, enter your best video.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, best video. Yeah. But I mean, I don't know what the payoff would be, right?
It's a weird
you
situation.
You get this artist in your video.
All true. Yeah. we got a few things on deck for what we're going to be doing next, but you know, we need your help, so just kind of like drop some comments if you guys don't mind, right in the comments. Let us know what you guys are thinking. If you're an artist, hit us up. Let us know, what should we do next, man?
I don't know, man. I mean, I like the whole ideas that we were coming with, man. I mean, you know, definitely the battle thing, you know, we were saying like a top 10 thing.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like, all right, when you think about it, who did you say was the top five Connect the Dot winners?
Overall
Connect the Dot winners, right?
I think like
no particular order.
I think honestly, I like,
when you look at all the winners we talked about.
I look at like Saipher, Soze, I like Specz, I like I really liked Lola for some reason. I liked Nigawana. I liked these are winners, right? But I liked Jay So Breezy. Like OG's sick. Fitted Kush. Jux Kane.
Jux, yep.
I don't know. Like, that's like those guys.
Yeah.
To name some, yeah. What about you?
Definitely Specz.
Oh, for sure, yeah.
Was a winner. Was good. Was up there. Saipher, Soze for sure. Specz.
Like Dre Specz?
Yeah.
See, I didn't really mention him because he's just like, to me, he's like been like on the tour.
Right.
Yeah. Like Specz, obviously, yeah, he's dope.
Well, I'm talking about the guys that won the contest. Not even won the contest or was like in the contest.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, those are guys that like won the contest.
Yeah, T Grams.
Like,
T Grams was
in there. Yeah, like T Grams was in there. But why do I not remember? Like, I don't know why he wouldn't win, or I don't know why he wouldn't be there. Cause I think T-Grams is dope.
I feel like he did perform at it, to be honest.
I think he just performed. I don't think he was in the contest.
Maybe, he might have done that anyway.
One of those ones.
Yeah, he might have pulled a heavy.
might have been those
what
ones.
What was your favorite event other than the two finals? Let's say Connect the Dot on a yacht, and let's say that big revival.
Well,
event.
I didn't finish my top five.
Oh, sorry. I thought you did, my bad.
No, I'm just trying to think, man. My top five, man. I had my three. You took too long. Oh, I took too long.
I'm joking. I was popping them out, bro.
Yo, come on right, now, right. man. You were just dropping names. Wasn't it Jay So Breezy?
Jay So Breezy. Yeah,
I liked him.
Mm-hmm.
I liked him. He was a dope winner. Yeah, I liked I like King Khan, man.
Yeah, he's dope.
I like what he did, man. Like
he rocked the crowd, man.
Yeah, he had an energy for you know.
I'll be honest, it was tough because in Ottawa for him, it, like you couldn't tell. Like it was like this is a free for all. Like it was like empty venue kind
of
deal.
I did a show out in Ottawa one time when I did the Freedom of Speech tour, and it was like by far the worst fucking show. It was the worst experience. I mean, Ottawa, you know, shout out to Ottawa, whatever, but yeah, like, the events that I did out there, it didn't leave a great taste.
You had Stitch, Specz, Jay Sobreezy, King Khan.
Let's see, who else was on there? Lola killed London.
Yeah,
she killed it, man. She destroyed London. Yeah. Like she that was like play. she was like woo, that was a hard performance. That was a really really hard performance, man.
That was a good show.
Yeah, that was a really sick one.
That was gonna be my question. Yeah. So, what was your, other than the finals were in Toronto, and other than the finals in both finals in Toronto, other than the yacht one, and other than the revival finals, what was your favorite show?
Other than, you said?
Yeah, other than those two, because like those two are like the obvious ones. Those were the finals. One was a yacht, one was at revival, like, you know what I mean?
That Durham one, on that first four leg connect the dot tour that we did, the one in Durham,
the Mustache Club one.
Was it Mustache Club? The one where Schizo won it.
Oh, okay. I still think it was Mustache Club. Yeah, it was.
That was a pretty dope one.
Yeah.
That was a pretty dope connect the dot. The London one, for sure.
The one at the Old East.
Yeah.
I think that was...
That was probably one of the best ones.
Yeah. That was one of the best ones. That one in the Oshawa Mustache Club.
Yeah. Those were the two that were popping. You know, Nocturne had some good ones.
We had a really good one at Nocturne, I remember.
Nocturne had a lot of good ones, man.
I think the one where we did the mannequin challenge was actually a really good one.
That was Nocturne.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I'm saying, I think that was a really good
one. That was Nocturne.
Yeah, man. I think that's pretty dope, though. So, episode one, podcast one, website, merch, playlist. Things to be expecting. Podcast is here. Those things are coming. Other stuff gonna be coming.
We got so many ideas on the table right now, you know, and the fact that we're talking about it and we're here and mentioning all that.
We're committing to putting time in once a week for this. So
I mean, it's like it's just like, you know, we got a lot of things on. We wanna know, who do you think is, you know, who comes to mind when you think of like the first artist that we should interview on here?
It's a no-brainer for me. That's a good idea. Who should we interview? But also, who should be featured on our playlist? Tag artists that we should be looking into. Like, who? What videos should we be looking at for our top 10? We want to do the top 10 next week. We're planning on doing it. So as you're seeing this, a week from today, we're planning on filming a top 10, whether it's music video or artist. We might even do a top 10. Artists of Connect the Dot, like history, even, or something, and maybe just kind of go over that. But we're gonna start doing top tens.
Yeah,
we'll make that another video. Yeah. So something that's not an hour and 2 hours long, easier to kind of watch for people. Like we'll come up with some quick content. The podcast is for the people that really want to tune in and really want that extra information. Yeah. So again, if you are watching this, thank you, and obviously you are one of those people that. We're actually making this for. So again, like, we don't want to just, we can have this conversation on the phone. You know, Mike doesn't have to come here
for sure.
You know, if you guys want this stuff, then let us know.
Like, why not, man? I mean, you're gonna be at home anyways, and you know, it's COVID. It's everyone's at home. We're supposed to be at home.
But
we're here, and you know, we're doing our thing, and you know, trying to definitely, like, you know, branch out and give it to the audience, you know, because you know, you deserve it. People deserve it. Like, it's for the culture. If you're a fan of the culture, like we're a fan of the culture, then you deserve it, right? And like that's what it's got to be.
So we're doing it for you guys. We hope you guys like it. We hope you enjoy it. We're gonna probably play some music at the end, quick, just like one song. Maybe every week we'll kind of do something like that.
Yeah, for sure.
Too. We'll do like a little feature song at the end. Yeah,
feature
everybody.
Video, feature artist.
I know some people were talking to me about, oh, maybe me and Gutz should do a radio show. Like, I don't know, that might be too much, but you know, maybe we'll do like a hosting for like the playlist or something.
Maybe.
Or, I don't know. We'll figure out some stuff, guys. Yeah. We're gonna get innovative with it. We're gonna keep redeveloping, and we need your guys' help. So that's why we're asking for comments. We're asking you guys to subscribe. Asking for that stuff.
Hit the like button. Hit the subscribe button. Share the content. Right? Like, you know, let us know if that you should be the artist that we're interviewing. You know,
put on there. If you got an artist, hit us up.
Like, you know, if you want to, you know, push your brand, like, you know, that's what we're gonna do. Like, you know, we want to get.
We have the Instagram connected.tv popping. You guys can hit us up on there, but you know, hit us up directly on our own personals. We'll hit you back. You know, at Director Dan Barker on Instagram.
Yeah, at the real Mike Gutz or at Mike Gutz Official.
Right, hit us up on those social medias. We'll get back to you guys ASAP. We're gonna have some stuff coming up for you guys. We hope you enjoy it again.
Yeah,
and we'll see you guys next week on the tripod, back at the Connected Dot Podcast episode 2. Yeah. Who knows how this is gonna develop? We'll see what happens.
We'll see
maybe
what
next
happens,
week man. We'll have freaking Drake here.
Yeah, maybe.
Who knows?
Maybe.
Right?